Okay, we made it to Japan today.
What did we do?
we got to the airport. It was a four-hour delay on our flight, or a two-hour delay on our flight. And we took a train because the buses were canceled. We took a subway and we're finally getting to step outside. We turned a corner in the subway station for exit number one and we looked up and this is what we saw. So this is our first steps outside in Japan. Very excited to be here.
It's not as cold as it looks.
It feels like it's minus a few degrees. My feet are soaking wet now. Just walked through a huge puddle. Cannot wait to get out snowboarding. It just dumped a whole bunch of snow today, which is why our flight was late, which is why buses were canceled. So it's gonna be pretty epic snowboarding in the next couple days. Now all we have to do is find our Airbnb. So yeah, once we get there, we're tired as hell and we're just gonna crash. See you tomorrow. It's March 2nd. And this is what it looks like here. Why in the world did we come here?
I can answer that by telling you what we just did. Okay. We came to the station was to book our bus and lift tickets to go snowboarding for the day tomorrow.
We are going snowboarding at Niseko Resort, which is the biggest, most powder-filled ski resort in Japan. We're psyched for snowboarding. This has been a lifelong dream of mine and I'm glad to share it with this lady. And now we're gonna walk down the streets of Sapporo to the Sapporo Beer Museum. Sapporo bought Sleeman Brewing in Guelph, so that's our little home connection to Sapporo. So we're heading this way through the streets of Sapporo to find the beer museum. All right, we have been walking for about 20 minutes. Well, first of all, let's notice all the snow drifts everywhere. Yes.
There were a couple that were taller than Sterling.
Yes, there have been snow drifts taller than me. Apparently this was built in the late 1800s. It originally started off as a beet sugar refinery, and then eventually other countries in Asia started being able to produce sugar for much cheaper. So they had to change gears. I don't know exactly where the shift to beer came from, but eventually it shifted to beer production. So this is not actually where Sapporo's brewed today, but this is the beer museum in the city. So we're gonna go learn about it a bit. It's free to get in, but obviously you have to buy beer. So we're gonna have a little sampling. If anyone knows us, they know we love beer. That's pretty much our thing, so. We came to the Sapporo Beer Museum to take a tour and learn about the history of Sapporo. And
got here in the nick of time.
Yeah, we also came to taste the beer, but we knew this place was open until 8. What we didn't know is that the last call for beer is 6:30. We got here at 6:27.
Ordered so, at 6:28.
Yeah, so we just made it. So, success.
Sapporo!
Cheers. For the night, we're gonna get some cup of noodles and some protein bars so that we can eat on the cheap tomorrow. We're going snowboarding, we're super excited, and because we're spending like $180 each for a day of snowboarding, we're gonna be eating cup noodles and protein bars, and that's about it for a few days to balance it out. Bananas, that's it. So we're going to the discount store called Don Quixote, and we're gonna get cheap stuff to balance out our expensive Japanese ways. This is it for tonight. We have to get up at like 6 o'clock in the morning tomorrow for snowboarding, so we're signing off. We're gonna go here and go to bed.
today's the day.
7:15 in the morning. We're going to the bus station to catch a bus to go snowboarding! Driving through the mountains to get to Niseko ski resort for the day. I have never been somewhere where it snows so much. And remember, I'm Canadian. Here's the roadside stop that we're stopped at. It's like taller than a bus. We're driving along this highway right over here. You might be able to see the road signs in the distance. The snow drifts are higher than the road signs. I don't even know how they plow this highway. This is crazy. We are at Niseko Ski Resort.
Woo!
It is four ski resorts actually, because this hill is huge and has four bases. So this is called the Grand Hirafu Resort. We rented gear. I don't know if you can see how snazzy Miriam looks here in her rental gear. We rented everything, coats, pants, all of it, boards. I've got some snaz gear as well. The whole shebang, Burton boards. Keeping with my green theme. And yeah, we will be heading up. It is so snowy here that the top of the mountain is actually closed because it's recently snowed over 500 centimeters. So you can get up about 3/4 of the way and we should be able to ski between a couple of the different bases. Super excited. So here we go. We'll see you on the hoop.
But if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like you've been here before? How I'm beginning to be an optimist about this. How I'm beginning to be an optimist about this. We were caught up and lost in all of our vices. Tumbling down in the city that we love. Great clouds roll over the hills, bringing darkness from above. But if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all?
Unreal. I love it. I love it. So glad we got to come here. One day this year we get to go snowboarding, and this is the one day. Wow. Okay, day is done. Snowboarded our butts off.
Whew.
And we got some food, and we're catching a bus in like 20 minutes, so we got to get there. But just want to do one last shot to show y'all the crazy snow here. It snows here, I don't know if we told you, a lot. Look at this. There's no wall here. This isn't a wall, this is just snow. If the snow weren't here, it would be flat ground. Like, there are no walls, there's straight snow. That pile of snow there, that's where they put all the snow. If it's not a mountain or a hill, that's just a pile of snow. If it weren't snowstorming the entire day and afternoon and whatever, you'd be able to see a large mountain in front of you. But because it's snowing, all you can see is what looks to be maybe a small hill. Trust me, it's big. We were going for 4 hours nonstop and we only did about 6 or 7 runs. Oh, amazing.
Yeah.
We
it was awesome.
Are spent going home. By the time we get there, it's gonna be nighttime. No more video.
If you're ever in Japan, you have to come here.
Yeah, come here.
Niseko.
Niseko Resort.
Well, this is it for Sapporo. We had our last day here yesterday where we kind of hung out at the little Airbnb place here and got caught up on some video and packing and stuff like that. And we got our train tickets all set up for Tokyo. We are on our way to Tokyo today. We're taking two high-speed trains because it's a hell of a long way from here. It's going to take us about 9 hours, so we're going to be on train all day. Now we have no time at all, so we got to get ready, have a breakfast, and go to Tokyo. See you there.